This video will show you how to create a Moodle quiz and how to create and organize questions and categories in the question bank. A Moodle quiz is an online assessment tool within Moodle that allows faculty to create and administer quizzes, tests, or exams. Quizzes can include a variety of question types, including multiple choice, true and false, or even essay, matching, or drag and drop questions. It can be used for both formative and summative assessments. We'll start with the question bank. From your course's main page, locate the question bank link under the right-hand administration menu and click it. You'll have a few different options here at the top to go to the question page or categories. If we click questions, we can see a list of questions used in the course. Switching this drop-down menu to categories shows us a list of all of the categories that are available in our Moodle course. Categories are used to help organize questions and are only ever seen by faculty. You can see the name of each category here, as well as the number of questions shown next to each in brackets. You can move question categories here with the arrows or adjust the settings if you need to. If you click any of the category names, it will open that category and show you all of the questions that are within it. So here we can see we've got 5 questions in the color theory category, on a variety of different topics, and a variety of different question types. You can see if they're used on any quizzes in these first 2 columns, and you can see the type of question that they are. The first one here is an essay, for example. This one's a matching question. These 2 are multiple choice, and the last one is a true and false. You have a few different actions you can take by clicking Edit. You can edit a question by clicking the Edit button. You can duplicate it, which creates a copy of it that you can then edit. You can also preview the question or delete it. If you need to add a new category, we go back to the categories page by clicking the drop-down menu here and click add a category. Here you can add a name for the category and choose what the parent category is. This is just asking where it's going to be sorted under. If I want it in the same kind of level as color theory and Sudbury questions, I'd put it under the parent category of default. Click the Add Category button, and that's going to add a new category for us. Let's go ahead and add a new question. We're going to put it in the Sudbury questions category, so I'm going to click that one to open it. And then I'm going to click this button here in the middle of the page that says Create a New Question. You'll see there's a lot of different question types that you can add to Moodle. They've got everything from multiple choice to essay and calculation questions and other advanced ones below. If you click the little dot next to it, it'll show you a little description here on the right side for that question category type. One thing to note is the difference between short answer questions and essay. Short answer questions allow a response of one or a few words, and they're kind of like fill in the blank. They must match the template that you match exactly. So if you want a question that you're going to get a longer response that you're going to be grading manually for each student, that would actually be an essay question. Let's go ahead and add one of those to show you what that looks like. Here, you'll put in a question name. This is only something that faculty will see, and it helps you identify and sort questions quickly. So we can give it a name and then type the question text here. You can choose the default mark here for how many points it's going to be worth. And then you can adjust some options here if you want students to add plain text or a file, for example, you could adjust that here. We'll click Save Changes, and that will bring us back to the category page, which now shows us this question. If I want to see what it looks like, I can click Edit next to it and then Preview. This is how it will appear on the test for students. I'll click the button here below to close the preview. And we'll add a new question. So once again, click Create a New Question, and this time we'll add a simple multiple choice question. We'll do the same thing and give it a name and some question text. And then we scroll down a bit and we have some more options. If only one answer is correct, then we can leave that here under one or multiple answers. If it's a choose all that apply kind of question, you can choose to allow multiple answers by switching that box. You can choose to shuffle the answer choices, which are your A, B, C, and D options, or uncheck that if you don't want them shuffled. Then we put our answers to the question in these boxes here under the choices. So we'll add a few different provinces. So Ontario, Alberta. And then we have to adjust the grade for whichever answers are correct. So in this case, Ontario is the only correct answer. So it will be worth 100% of the mark. If students pick Ontario, they get 100% of the mark. If they pick anything else, they get none. So you'll notice too that you have the option to give a different percentage of the mark. If you have two answers that are correct, you could split it 50-50, for example. You can also weight things with negative marks. So if you do have a multiple choice question that has multiple answers which are correct, you might want to penalize incorrect responses. So you could even make them worth a negative value here. So in this case, we just have Ontario as the single correct answer, which is worth 100% of the grade. And then I will click Save Changes at the bottom. And we'll preview that just to make sure it looks okay. So again, click Edit, Preview. And this is what the question will look like. I can even choose the button here to fill in the correct response, which is Ontario. So now we'll go and create a quiz. So at the top of our Moodle page here, we'll click the course button to return to the course main page. And then I'm going to find the section that I want to put the quiz in. Let's say we want it in section 3, and click Add Activity or Resource. From here, I'm going to find quiz, which is this red icon with the check mark. And we'll give it a name. You can also add a description with some instructions or any other information you'd like here. And you can display that on the course page if you like. Under timing, you'll find important settings about when the quiz opens and closes, as well as the time limit that's allowed for students. So we can choose to enable an open date and close date. So it is between these times that students will be able to complete the exam or the quiz. So let's say we want to set it for July 10th, between 10 o'clock and noon. So in this case, students could write the exam between 10 o'clock and by noon on that same day, July 10th, it would close. We can also add an optional time limit. This can be useful if you want to keep your window of timing open for a longer period of time. Maybe you want it open from 10 a.m. until, say, 11:59 p.m., but you want students to only have 1 hour once they hit begin. So the time limit will actually display a countdown once students start their attempt. They could start it, for example, at 10 a.m. They could start it at 5 p.m. on this day, but regardless of when they start it, it will only allow them a 60-minute time limit. Under grade, the only thing we usually change here might be to change the number of attempts allowed. If it is a practice quiz or something like that, you could give them multiple attempts, or you could give them even unlimited attempts, but for most, it's just one single attempt. On the layout page, you can choose how many questions are displayed on each page. If I want every question to be on a separate page, I can choose that here. And we can adjust the navigation method. So what the navigation method does is allows you to determine whether students can navigate back and forth or just proceed in a sequential manner. So sequential means that they can answer questions one at a time in order, and they cannot return to questions that they've answered previously. Free navigation just means that students can go backwards and forwards and preview things again if they choose to. So under question behavior, we don't really adjust those most of the time. And the other important section is the review options here. So I just want to point out too that with most things in Moodle, you'll see these little question mark icons. And if you click it, It gives you a little description of what each of these settings mean. This can be helpful when you're trying to figure out what all of them are and what the difference is between settings here. So this gives you a little bit of information about the different time things here. The one that's most important in this case is usually after the quiz is closed. So if you set a closing date here in your timing, so for example, July 10th at 23:59, which is 11:59 p.m., after that closing date, you can choose to allow students to view certain things or nothing. The attempt is going to be whether they can see their attempt at all, which means they can see all of their questions and what answers they chose. So for example, on question one, if they chose C, they will see that. If they chose B for question two, they'll also see that. You can choose to show whether that is correct and the marks associated with it. So this will give them a total score, as well as showing each question and how many points each question was out of and how many they received. There's feedback built within the questions, and if you add those in the question settings themselves, you can choose to show that here, and you can also show them the right answer if you like. Under the extra restrictions on attempts, there is the option to require a password for students. Sometimes faculty like to add a password that students will be prompted for before they begin their exam, which can be useful if you want to make sure that students don't start it before you're in class and give them some instructions first, so you could add that password there. And the rest of the settings we don't typically adjust or need to change anything with. So once you've added all of your settings and adjusted them, click Save and Display. So now we can see that our time that we specified is here in our little description. There's one attempt allowed and they have a time limit of 1 hour. You'll notice that no questions have been added yet to this quiz. So we've just created the blank quiz and adjusted the settings. Now we can go ahead and add some questions to it. You can either click Add Question here at the top, or on the right side of the quiz, you'll notice the questions under the administration settings, so you can click that as well. This shows you the questions page where you can see all of the questions on our quiz. To add a question, all we have to do is click the Add button here, and then we get three options. We can add a new question, in which case we're just going to create a question from scratch. And it's similar to how we created a question in the question bank, only we're doing it right on the quiz. Once you do this, you'll note, let's say we add a true false question. You will note that it's asking you which category to place the quiz into. So if I'm making a quiz about, or I'm making a question now about Sudbury, you can choose to put it in that category. I'll just hit cancel to return back to our main page. You can also add questions from the question bank. If I have specific questions that I want to add, that I want every student to receive, I can choose from my question bank which categories to add. So right now it's showing all of the questions here, or if I want to pull ones specifically about color theory, let's say I want every student to get this essay question, I will select it here and click Add to Quiz. So now I can see that it's added one question onto the quiz. That question is also worth 5 marks. If you want to change that, you can click the little pencil icon, update the number, and press enter. So now it's only worth 3 marks. The other option you have is to add random questions. Random questions can be useful because they can pull from a category a certain number of questions that you specify. So every student then will receive a potentially different group of questions on their quiz. So let's pull from the Sudbury questions that we added. I'll choose that category here, and then I can choose the number of random questions I want. So here are my 4 questions. I want every student to receive 2 different questions from this category. And so now I'll add random questions. So now we can see that it's added 2 random questions, and in brackets here, it's noting that it's from the Sudbury questions category. You can click See Questions to jump to that category again in the question bank to see all of the questions that are in there. We can also adjust the maximum grade on this page. At the top of the page, you'll notice that the total number of marks is noted here, and in this case we just have 5, but the maximum grade is displaying as out of 100. So by default, Moodle quizzes are graded out of 100, but you could change it to match the total number of marks on the quiz. So we'll just update that to 5 and click Save. The other option you can do is to shuffle questions. It's not so much of a concern when you have random questions that are pulled and are already randomized, but if you have just a bunch of questions on each exam and you want it to change the order that each student receives, you can click this shuffle button right here. So now we've added some questions in the question bank. We know how to add categories and adjust those, and we know how to create a quiz. The only other options here that we can talk about is to remind you that the user overrides if students require extra accommodations or extra time or to write at a different date is here under overrides. And you can also preview a quiz by clicking preview. So we always recommend that you preview your quiz just to make sure it's displaying properly. So once you start the attempt, this is similar to what it looks like for students. They can see the quiz navigation here in the top right side with the number of questions, and we're seeing that they're getting this essay question first, which they can type into here. And then they should be getting random questions pulled here. So we'll just go through, preview it. Everything looks good. Perfect. So now if you need to adjust the settings, you can do so by clicking here. If you need to adjust the questions, you can click questions. And that's it. So that's all there is to it. Once you're satisfied, you can go back to your Moodle course and the quiz will be shown. And you can adjust the title or any of the settings that you need here. So once the open date occurs on Wednesday, July 10th, students can begin their quiz. If you have any questions about quizzes, question banks, or categories, please let us know in the Teaching and Learning Innovation Hub.